Alright, every time there's rain forecast in a race, like there is for this one, it's always a dry start. But the racing soul is right here. Decades of F1. One of the things I would like them to change in the future, including the 1989 seven seasons, every rain forecast race starts dry. Even if it's dry for like a lap. Of course, we've got the Mercedes driver there, but Caroon, how are they? But I'd like them to design like where it could be raining at race start. It's a well-deserved pole position and a great. It's something that, for whatever reason, just never happens. Well, as we can see, the crowd here at the Hungaro Ring are ready and waiting, so let's get the show underway. Also, like in the F1 series, I have issues with mechanical failures, but in a sim game, mechanical failures for a little bit more like randomness. Oh, halfway. I don't think that the hards are the best. Yeah, not even the hards reach the rain. Something like soft medium. Probably like gonna be inners at 40. We just have one set. Well, I'm just saying, I've played a lot of these, and they never... I've never seen a rain start. Unless there's been a red flag. If there's a red flag, it tends to happen. Alright, let's race. There's a fantastic atmosphere at the Hungaro Ring. I played this game a lot. 70 laps of the Hungarian Grand Prix. Everyone in the paddock seems to be talking about the Mercedes. Basically what I'm saying, and I've never seen it happen. They're on pole, and it's well deserved. I'm looking forward to seeing what they can do. So many hours into this that I'm convinced it's not possible. Because the game just hard-coded against it.
And here we go. With the Hungarian Grand Prix.
Oh, we do have AI taking hard tires.
And it's lights out, and away we go.
All right, let's
overtake.
I just looked at my radometer and I just decided that it wasn't going to...
Single yellow.
Yeah, copy.
There's a yellow flag now.
Watch for debris.
Mick crashed. Oh!
I'm very, 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 very sorry.
Just reduce your speed.
I think we're gonna extend to lap 20 on the soft.
To save tires in high speed.
Battle assist. I just need to wait for them to, like, actually... like, burn off their battery, and then I can, like, actually try to get away. I'm fairly certain that they're not making it to the rain period on hards. That's just like for like like a really poor start from Leclerc. Montoya might just be useless for support in this one. His driving skills are like getting there, but it's taking time. Williams has done surprisingly well in development in this game.
DRS enabled.
Like, I'm not even... I want to peek at the GG app here quick. I can. It's gonna come up over my screen. My sound's being weird, so I'm just seeing if there's an update. It's been being weird at times. Okay, Ocon's just trying to launch away.
Stay close to him.
I hope I don't regret not defending this. I'm going to regret not defending this. Clara locked her up.
So here we go, heading into turn one.
The Ferrari's just fighting each other.
The wheels just lock up there.
Jeez.
By that point, it was just too late.
Let's turn up the ERS now. Not necessarily expecting this to be the decisive run. Thanks for not actually pulling by. Yeah, we're supposed to... Now we're working kind of hard.
If we could just drop back a bit.
I guess the real question is, if we need to, how deep can this tire go? 45. Would the hard be preferable? No. No, absolutely. We should be wet by lap 45. What I'll do is I'll extend. We'll extend the softs to lap 20. That'll give like the mediums like the ability to run to 47. That should put us in a good position to finish. Issue with trying to get away is that the AI is actively going to fight that. We're going to end up like slower anyway as well. Stroll. That's an easy one.
Just a reminder on DRS, and we need to look after these tires.
Let's have a look. Nice.
Look at the Mercedes.
There's an accident to watch too.
And the Mercedes climbs higher up the field.
And that accident looks serious.
Oh dear, a crash! There's been a crash!
Was the AlphaTauri... No, it was the McLaren, this was at Norris, and
tries to get by.
And the Aston Martin. Car
involved in that, as you can see.
Debris everywhere.
So there was a crash.
Okay.
A lot of debris.
I'm pretty happy with the lead we've built up now. Then we need a little bit of top up.
Yep.
So we don't run out of battery and get caught back up. Which, yeah. Probably gonna lose a couple tenths here. By Norris. The second stint, I think, is going to be definitive for us. Montoya's race is looking okay so far. I don't mind where he's at. I don't see any winglet damage to Norris. But yeah, he's got to be compromised. And it was either Gasly or Sainz. I don't see winglet damage to either one of them, though, either. Mm-hmm. footage, sorry. We're approaching the raw end of this tire life now. I do think our best tactic is to wait till like lap 20. Need to try to beat Magnuson off of me. Yeah, he's within DRS. That battle's lost.
Just manage these tires.
I just stopped pushing because there isn't a point now. Magnuson is like killing those tires off really quick. Am I at high overtake? No. I don't want to be because it's just. High overtake aggression means more chance of incidents. Okay. just the mind's wandering a bit. Yeah, the hard's kind of phase over the soft's really quick once it starts happening. That's kind of the danger we're in now.
It's not going to be long now, mate.
Copy.
Everyone's kind of having their turn at it now.
We've got a yellow flag here.
Oh boy. I didn't even see who crashed. The thing must have come up before it, Oh, it's back here. Time penalty Albon causing a collision. Leclerc seems like the most likely. I don't think there's any signs that this is going to... I'm worried about these mediums peeling in and nothing really changing. That's what I'm worried about. We're at optimal, let's ignore. Probably the two laps before the pit stop, we will turn the engine up, or turn the drive up. I mean, I have like no grip now. Yeah, we have no mechanical grip. Do we give in or do we stay out?
Push and get past him.
Joe is in and he's on, yeah, okay, he's on the side. Tire usage is a little bit higher than I would like. We haven't overheated though, so that's a plus. Let's go down to aggressive.
Reduce your speed.
Copy.
And this lap, we're gonna stick them mediums on.
So box, box.
Copy.
DeVries, medium pit stop. And then we wanna get Montoya in there on the mediums as well.
Box now, box.
Alright, I'm just trying not to use all of the tire at once. We're gonna have at least a little bit left.
Let's give it everything we got.
Yeah, copy.
Magnussen, same lap.
Yeah, copy that.
Norris on hards, but unreal.
I'm going into pit lane now.
Yeah, just keep an eye on your mirrors for cars coming.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
And watch a white line on exit.
Thank you.
Push and hold, overtake.
Yeah, copy.
Ocon is on hard. What a strange tire to be on.
Take care of the tires.
Yeah, okay.
I'm just pushing my way through this field. Oh!
Oh my goodness.
Awesome job, mate. Currently P4. VSC, VSC. That's positive.
Yeah, copy.
That was kind of unfortunate.
So there was a crash. And what, debris around the track?
Because now the AI that haven't pitted yet are getting cheap pit stops. We should still get by every one of these guys.
So Gasly's just pitted.
Definitely a boon to everyone that stayed out. And Verstappen goes and gets a cheap stop.
VSC ending.
Yeah.
Happy to start reducing that management.
We're in the lead, which...
pushing status.
It's fine and fair.
DRS has been enabled.
Russell, I just very much would have preferred. Be on green flag.
So deployed.
Copy.
Yeah, we just want to grow this gap.
Alright, let's back and go. We're gonna set the fastest lap barrier down a little bit more, even. A whole bunch of cars ahead of Montoya got cheap pit stops, and that's just crappy. we're pretty much another VSC. Another full, not full back off, but
now we've got an incident
tire wear back up.
It, George Russell's involved.
Oh wow.
This happened as they arrived at turn 12. You can see how tight it is.
Oh.
You can see how the cars come together. A bitter blow.
Ocon's car is on fire.
Driver from the pack.
Wow. That's a game changer. Ocon and Russell are both out.
Virtual safety car deployed. Stay as close as possible to the Delta.
Okay, copy, copy.
That's going to be championship altering, potentially. Russell gets a penalty. It'll probably end up being a grid penalty in the next race. He did rear-end him. Kind of goes without saying, doesn't it? This is going to bring in the rain a little bit sooner. Post rain period, it's going to be pretty boring. Stroll is on the soft tire, which is theoretically bad, but it's going to probably end up working in his favor for the rain period, because we're spending so much time in VSC now. Wow. That's the end of VSC.
Copy.
We need to burn this fuel off now.
Copy. Your eyes enabled.
And we got a push.
Okay, let's see what you got then.
Thank you.
DRS.
Copy, copy.
What is happening?
2 sec. There's been a crash.
Norris and Magnussen. I ought to have been behind me. Seem much of a point in like preserving our tires. So that 2VSC since switching onto this tire. No penalties given. Yeah, if we want the fastest lap, we need to like lock it in like right now. Now I'll take it easy. Verstappen soft. Okay. Max kind of surged forward. Given where the rain's coming, this is probably not going to work out well for us. Unless Max's tires are to like die on us. Chair wide. Again, aggressive lunge from Max. Albon and Mick.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
That was a pretty hefty hit.
We think there is some rain coming.
Coming.
There is some rain coming.
Coming, coming.
Just getting stomped on. Montoya is. That first VSC was really bad for him. Right, he's second behind that too. Pretty solid as far as like our pace relative to Magnussen. Take a slight bit. That's how to make things harder for Magnussen. Verstappen is starting to fall apart in pace. We don't have that much longer before the rain comes in, though.
Let's just manage these tires.
And we need to take
out. Yeah, they just
tires.
Die. Sausage is dying. Says dry for like the next 12 minutes doesn't mean that we're not going to be pitting, because once you get above 0.8, the inners do arguably get faster. They can start outperforming worn like dries, for instance. Verstappen's going down. The rain isn't going to come fast enough to save Stroll from losing fourth, I don't think, either. don't know how good Montoya is in the rain either. It's a bit of a worry. Lap 41, I'm thinking. Magnus is doing me a pretty big favor in killing his hards quicker than we have to worry about. I'd be worried about him phasing over us, but with the way he's burning them, I don't think that's going to be a problem. I want to pick up a little bit more. We're at optimal 4 tire stop. Yeah, just get him.
Try to look after the tires.
We'll slow down.
Just to reduce your speed.
That's kind of where we cry uncle at this point. DeVries, I think, moved too quick. I don't think that's a good move. What are we looking at here? Point eight's kind of critical.
Mm-hmm.
That's about where we're going to see the tires, like, not overheating. Hey, Rikas, how you doing, sir? Depends on what you need help with. Let's stagger their pit laps. We're at 0.8 now, so well, we're almost there.
I'm in the pit lane.
Copy.
But to help you, I need to know what you need help with first, and then once I know, we can maybe go from there. Season 3, researching every part still behind. I ran into this problem with McLaren. I was slowly climbing the field, actually. Like, researching my headquarters and everything. If you haven't stripped weight off of your components yet, it's one of the quickest ways to find, like, a couple tenths of a G in everything. You have to replace everything more often, but
I'm in the pit.
You get raw pace, and you need to do it for almost everything. There's a couple components you don't want to strip all the way, because stripping them all the way, like, makes it, like, 1-3 races instead of 2-4. And ideally, you want everything to last 2-4. It's like chassis, underbody, rear wing. I think all strip all the way without being too detrimental to the wear. Magnuson's there. And, it's at 70 degrees. Go figure. But yeah, at standard weight, there's only so much you can do in development. You can research your way, like, if you get a, like, significant enough, research advantage, but yeah, it's really hard to counteract the AI, because the AI does strip their components a little bit on weight so that they can go faster. Every season subsequent to, like, getting McLaren to the top, I've had to strip at the beginning of the season to stay ahead in Arrow. He's fine. He's actually fine. He's almost up to temperature, and Magnuson isn't, like, clawing in, like, overly fast. They are. I'm just trying to wear the tires slower than the AI. With inners, it's a little less important, I guess, but I like to try to not, burn mine too fast. I think we might trend towards heavier tire wear here. Oh yeah, he's burned his battery. The main thing is to not panic. Because once the track damps out, he won't be able to use DRS to overtake. And it gets a lot harder to overtake at that point. If he does close into DRS, I might need to start worrying, though. I'm burning Montoya's battery to keep trying to keep Verstappen behind. I did not. I took over the team after. I had McLaren for the first five. And they got rid of Russell, like, at the end of season 3. That ain't good. Now I do need to worry a little bit. This lap is important to keep him behind, and then after that, he won't have DRS anymore. Let's go high overtake aggression, because I think this is our last chance to get by Verstappen. And after this, the DRS is going to close off. Just turn that, please. I don't think so. It fluctuates around a little bit, but I don't think it actually dips back under again. What does Magnus's battery? Yeah, okay. We're on the right end of this. We're in the front running car, disrupting his air. I think it's going to be like this for the rest of the race. Hopefully Magnussen just punishes the tires and we just get a wear advantage. Fortunately, I don't think that the inners actually do start degrading until 75%. I'll be right back. I gotta step out for a minute. It's not impossible to overtake without DRS, but it does get a lot harder. The AI, fortunately, is very bad at it. The rain has kind of broken down, or not Verstappen, but Magnussen. Verstappen is losing time too.
Charge the pack.
Yeah, copy.
I just take care of the car and bring her in. Magnussen's in second, yeah. Williams is kind of a podium contender, and they have been for a while. They're not consistent, but they are able to contend. Sonoda and Magnussen kind of take turns being the better driver. I've lost a race to Sonoda before, I'm pretty sure. With Mercedes. When McLaren was top contender, I never lost to Williams. Won a Constructors with McLaren in season 4 and 5, and then I've won for Mercedes in 6. And now we're going first. 4 straight, 2 with Mercedes on season 7. Strategically, there's not really much of anything to do here. If I get close enough to Joe, I can just send the car and try to take him. Oh, thank you for the follow, Rikas. I appreciate it. Let's push in. See if we can make something happen.
DRS? Copy.
The best time is when they've used DRS. It's all but impossible to overtake AI if they've got battery to burn themselves. And you don't have DRS. Break. Now I just have to out traction. That's all she takes. We probably have a theoretical maximum of 5th place here.
Just take care of the tires for the moment.
Copy.
Let's get to some management. Turn 5.
Maloney's 89 overall, and Montoya is 83. Been working on Montoya for years, and we put him in around 80, 81 overall. With McLaren, I had Norris Piastri for the first 2. And that was Norris Ocon for the next 3. He's F2. I think he might be F2. He might... I don't remember where... He started pretty low. He might have even been an F3. Looks like it's Formula 3 that he said no. So that would make sense if he was started, or if he started in F3. Alonso and Lando. Alonso goes surprisingly far into these games. You have to really keep up your drivers after they hit 30, though, I think. If they stop doing well, they could just decline. Williams with Ocon, Sonoda. It's a good lineup. But he scored 4 while Ocon 25. Stroll is like 92 or 93 overall this save. Which I'm just like, that's really, really ridiculous. I just kind of was insulted by it. Magnussen does seem to really fall apart in the rain. Kind of a shock to me. I don't think Maloney is particularly adaptable. So this is entirely unexpected. De Vries, where is he? If we start pushing a little bit, we can probably get him to fold.
So, deployed. Copy. So we need to push.
We'll try ERS only. It can be a difficult sell. We could potentially even reach Stroll here. That's probably as far as we'll get. Take him on the inside. Good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't let him back in. Okay. We'll push a little bit more.
No lift off needed. You are doing a good job.
Okay.
This would be 34 points to Stroll's 12. We still slightly trail, I think. Done multiple careers and never won a race. We have the normal difficulty too. Second, three times. That's not bad. It's not necessarily straightforward how you build to the top in this game, I will say. It took me 3 to 4 seasons to actually figure it out. The only little bit of encouragement I got, like, early on was people were telling me how they were getting fired from their careers. And I managed to survive. I managed to survive that fate at least. Alright, Gasly. He's got no ERS. Never been fired. I mean, that's... You're figuring out the game decently if you're managing to not get fired, because it's really hard. It is, like, very challenging. McLaren's goals actually do end up being pretty lofty for the... They start. So that's a really easy one to get fired from if you don't really know what you're doing. I think I barely survived the first season.
Charge on.
Okay.
Yeah, Lando punches them above their weight a lot.
And charge button off. Charge button off.
Especially early on. When I started, and they're like 7th, and I just was like clawing for like single points, I was like, how are we gonna do this? This is like, I'm not seeing a way. Alright, 36 to 12. At this rate, we trail constructors by 1 point. This season was weird, because we actually should have a constructors lead, but we ran into a lot of, like, bad luck with crashes and just, like, poor races. And I actually had a bad strategy call in a rain race, like, a few races ago, too. That took Maloney way out of the points. sometimes like the rain graph like goes up, but you're like, is that wet or is that just like between like 3.8 and 4.8? It's hard to tell the difference on that graph sometimes. Overtaking Stroll would be 26.12, would be 38 to 10. That puts us in the lead by 3 points. Ocon crashing out was huge. We probably don't have a chance to actually take the lead here without that happening. We'd have to like grind it out over a longer period of races. Verstappen's crash is actually very... his crash in rating, like when we sent him to McLaren. Because I signed him before leaving that team to McLaren. But he hasn't really come close to winning since. I love the really good facilities too. They don't really have an excuse. Thing about this game is like I've really like grown accustomed to the Mercedes engine. It's not outright the fastest, but it is like the most reliably fast as the engine wears. The most insane thing I tried like in last year's game was like Haas with the Ferrari engine. Like I just kind of squeaked close to the championship, and then I switched to the Red Bull engine the following season and just decimated Red Bull. Once they didn't have their engine advantage anymore, like it was just over. I took over Mercedes. It had finished ninth the previous season. So I took a team that was in shambles. And then let their facilities go. I had to like... I had to do a lot to turn it back over to where it should be. Where everything like should be set. Have lost a tenth. Let's collect some ERS now.
Charge button on.
See, Stroll, he's got some charge in that thing. We gotta try to bait him into using some.
It will be charge button off.
We should actually be fine to push the rest of the way now. The fuel saving when it rains is just nuts. Just insane. Yeah, that ERS has seen better days. What if that means he's less effective? Wow, that engine's seen better days too. No, I think fourth is top for him. Considering where he qualified, that's more than fine. I'm more than happy with that.
ERS?
He qualified in 12, so I mean... It was looking pretty bleak before the rain, so I'm just happy to be picking up positions right now. Burning with me.
Charge on.
Yeah, got copy.
I think we got him to use some. The efficiency of his ERS probably isn't the best. Maloney's is struggling, but we're not needing to use it too much, fortunately. This one is significant because I think this one actually does just enough to change the championship order, this overtake. It does just enough to take first from Red Bull, I think. Maloney is just crushing it. There's another tenth lost in there somewhere. Once the rain kind of came in and Magnussen didn't get by, like, his pace just collapsed. I think he was just trying to get it and then let the rain just hopefully save it for him. I'm not going to be unhappy with this result in general. This was a good race. Interesting to see if Norris actually gets Magnussen. Probably won't happen unless their ERS numbers are enough out of sync. AI seems to like burn like from about 80 to 75% down to about 20-25%, and then I think they just top up and then burn like in a cycle. Stroll's used all his ERS, so I think that one's over. Gotta go, be back. I'll probably be done later, but yeah. The race is almost over anyway, so. This is bad, I guess, gonna finish, etc., etc. Thanks for stopping by, though. Hopefully we will see you around here. Time in the future. Take care, sir. We're about to start final lap now. I don't know if the AI actually empties their batteries at the end. Stroll ain't necessarily gonna have enough to worry me. Stroll started the lap at 25%. Just from a sentimental standpoint, I kind of wanted to see Norris get second. Great teamwork. Yes. Yes, yes.
Check it, flak.
And B4.
An excellent result today for the Mercedes driver.
Incredible. That was a really well-deserved win. They got their race strategy absolutely spot on.
A great display of team spirit there, as everyone finally gets the chance to share this moment. And as proceedings start to wind down here, what will Mercedes have made of this result, Karim?
They'll be absolutely delighted to have picked up the win here. What a great outcome that is for the team.
And that then marks the end of our time here in Hungary.
Next time, the teams will be adding another year to the legend of Spa-Francorchamps. Anything can happen at the Belgian Grand Prix.
Okay. Yeah, 3 points. Just like I thought. Underfloor and suspension. Okay. We're getting a bonus point for qualifying. Doesn't seem to be anything else for us to do, so yeah. That is the end for me for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already done so, feel free to hit the follow button one time, sub, like, and share on the YouTube end of things. We will catch you guys again next time. Till then, later on.